Let me see if anybody gonna jump on here. See, what am I going to get into? Hello? Hello, how are you? I'm trying to see if some people going to chime in and see what I'm going to just chit-chat, talk about. I might pull a few cards today. I just really want to show up, you know what I'm saying, to let everybody know that they're loved. And your girl is always fearless. Yeah, because they tried to take me out again last night. But I'm still here. So I just want to show up just to share some energy. Just a happy new year. I just want to show up to share some energy. Say hello. Maybe pull a few cards. You know, I don't know. Just whatever comes through. I just want to show up today. You know, I was feeling kind of down earlier. I woke up this morning tired, feeling like they not, like I ain't had no life. I'm like, oh God. But I just muscled through it. I had to do a little bit of alchemy. And I was like, you know what? And my ancestors and God say, just show up. Go live. Just go live so they can see that God is real. Ain't nothing they can do. The pressure gonna only create a beautiful diamond of light. I'm still here. I don't know. I might pull some cards. You know what I'm saying? Just want to see what's going on with everybody else. Read the energy. What is the day, y'all? Today is the 3rd or 4th? What is the day? I don't even know what the day is. Day. Oh, it's January 3rd. See, that's what I be chilling. I was up pretty late last night working on my latest art piece. I might paint again later. You know, work on it some more. Just, you know, chilling, being creative, you know what I'm saying? I was messing with a little telekinesis earlier because that's what your girl like to do, too. I don't know, I just figured I'd show up and see what everybody doing. See how everybody doing, just to say hello, you know what I'm saying? Just to exchange energy, see what anybody want to talk about maybe. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I might pull a few cards. I just want to show up. I just want to jump online. I said I might try to start going live a little bit more, okay? To see what might come through, what channel messages might come through. But yeah, I was up on the heavy, when I say heavy, spiritual attacks last night. I felt terrible this morning. I felt lifeless, but I'm still here. As the day went on, I got me some electrolytes, drink me some coconut water, and, you know, just sat and chilled, and I don't know, I just decided to show up. I ain't doing nothing, though. I'm never doing nothing. I'm a homebody. I don't do nothing. I'm in the house all the time. That's why they can't touch me, too. They mad because your girl don't get out. I don't have no reason to. Get out for what? I mean, unless I'm going to do something, like, worthy of doing. I don't just go out like that. You know what I'm saying? And you got to have money to do some things. You know, it's free to go out. I've been in the house today. I've been in the house for days, you know. I have been up on a serious spiritual attack, though. But they just keep giving me these upgrades. I don't know what they're trying to give me my superpowers. Like, they want, these motherfuckers want me to teleport on their ass and just pop up on them, like, yeah, bitches, I'm here. Smack them in the face and then teleport up out of there. I just play. But I won't even smack them. You know what I'm saying? I might teleport and be like, oh, still here, bitches. Then boop, teleport up out of there. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of what I'm doing now. I'm teleporting right here online. Saying, hey, bitches, I'm still here. You know what I'm saying? And I teleport up out of here when I'm ready. But, yeah, I'm just showing up. I ain't doing nothing. I just wanted to show up. I don't know. Y'all want me to pull some cards? Y'all want me to do, you know, pull a few cards? See what the energy is. I guess that's what I do, Howie. I don't think nothing coming through. The cards will help me. Uh-oh. We got action moving here. Door to value. We all can use some of this. So, y'all, let's start with the energy deck. Let's just read the energy. I don't know, y'all. I might put my specs on in a minute. I already asked God and my ancestors to cover me, cover my platform, you know what I'm saying? Keep all the evil eyes and the naysayers and the haters and all the negative energy out, you know what I'm saying? If you see me the evil eye, then that's on you. You know what I'm saying? Somebody here is unbalanced. So somebody's trying to call somebody to be unbalanced so they won't walk into their door of value. Yeah, it's a decision that's going to have to be made, okay? Somebody's going to have to make a decision on something. Yeah, so some door won't get closed. I don't know. Somebody's trying to block somebody's cornucopia, but they can't. Look at this energy, y'all. We got money, cornucopias. Like, somebody don't want you to have this, but you're going to. All right? And the people that's unbalanced, this is going to be their energy. They're closing their own doors for trying to block yours. Okay? I don't know what's wrong with these people. Yeah, somebody not thinking straight. All right? This thinking woman in reverse. She don't realize or they don't realize whoever in this energy that you're going to still receive your cornucopia. Okay? Yeah, you're still going to come out of this financial constraint. Somebody's been really doing a lot of energy manipulation or spell work or something to try to stop somebody from receiving some type of abundance, fortune, success, whatever. The cornucopia is everything, all right? That's like the Ten of Cups energy. I mean, the Ace of Cups. So, you know what I'm saying? That's kind of what that is. So, somebody is going to manifest that or manifesting that, going to have that in their life. But it's another person, all right? Another energy that's been trying to block that, but they can't. They're going to fuck around and find out. They're going to lose everything. Because, baby, we full of love. We fearless. We always fearless. We ain't scared of nothing. Scared of what? But somebody got major door possibilities coming in. You know what I'm saying? It's like doors of opportunity finna open up for somebody. Yeah, whoever you are, you about to come out of anxiety. Like, you may have been dealing with a lot, trying to figure out which way to go. That's that indecisiveness. Like, what are you doing? Like, going in all kind of directions. Maybe you coming out of a lot of anxiety. You could have been dealing with it. You know what I'm saying? Worried about a lot of stuff. But spirit say you're going to come up out of this energy. No need to worry because it's a lot of opportunities that's coming for somebody. Okay? Look at this. It popped back up. Baby, you're going into your door to personal healing and happiness. Yeah, we ain't got nothing to be worried about. We fearless over here. We love too much to be having these doors shut on us. A lot of people throwing their negative energy to stop things. They can't stop nothing when you in divine love. It's like you're meant to have this. It's because you've done your healing. All right? So you manifesting this. It's here. No more. Like, the time is up. Like, it's right here. It's happening. Just accept it. Okay? What else? This is looking, I'm loving this. Ooh, what they gonna do? Because you shine bright like a diamond. What they gonna do? Baby, this is fulfillment. Something could be happening coming in. Like, I'm seeing a lot of spring. That's the channel message I got earlier, right? So, hello. That's the channel message I got earlier. Can I drop my question? I'm doing a collective right now, okay? I'm just reading for the collective. Let me put my glasses on so I can see what y'all seeing, because I ain't... Your eyes 41, so let me tag in my eyes too, but I can see energy and stuff, but when it comes to these devices and stuff, it gets funny, I don't know. Earlier, I was getting a channel message about, okay, I know we just said it that 2024, like January is a new year, and it's like these 3 months of winter is really still the last part of this year that we was in. Like, we're really not into the new year. As I know that March is really the new year, the spring, right? So I was getting that what's happening is these last winter, like during the winter months, like a lot of people still gonna be prominent at throwing negative energies, right? But it's like during this winter, like the energy that they throw, it might show up to you a little bit, but it's not gonna affect you as much as it even was doing last year, like in the beginning of last year. So these last 3 months of winter here, December, January, February, it's like the energy that they was throwing at you, you was feeling a little bit, but it wasn't affecting you. It's not going to affect you as much, and they're going to get it come back to them a little faster. But come March, if they throw any energy at you, you're not going to feel it at all. You're going to be in this energy right here. You're going to be like really dealing with like in a new situation. Like, you're going to be in a lot of peace, a lot of healing, right? So when they throw this energy, it's going to hit them instant. Like, it's not even going to show up in your life at all. So, it's like, that's the real new energy that you're going to be embodying. That's what you're going into. Like, but this winter, it's like a lot of stuff going to be really, really, really exposed. Like, a lot of secrets going to be coming out. Like, a lot of people are going to be dealing with a lot of karma. Like, it's going to the pressure going to get real. But it's going to be like, but the things that's meant for you going to be slowly unfolding. Like, all these opportunities are coming in for somebody, okay? So just trust the process. Because you're getting the victory, baby. You're getting the victory. You already won. You already won. You can't be beat. You can't be stopped. I keep saying when they throwing shit, they throwing diarrhea. It's not going to stick. Like, know that you already won. Like, you got all kind of things coming in for you. All kind of healing. All kind of happiness. All kind of joy. I mean, just... the doors is opening up, and it's here. It's here now. Like, you're coming out of anxiety. It's like a multitude of doors. I'm getting, you got more than one door. As we seen in the beginning, the door to value was the first one that came out. So, yeah, I know I'm working on my latest painting. It's an umbrella, and it's money raining down. Like, money. It's gold coins, dollars. Like, it's just diamonds just falling from the sky. Like, you're going to be having all kind of abundance coming in for you, and can't nobody stop it. Okay? Baby, I don't know if nobody wants you. I'm telling you something. If somebody wants you, baby, you will have to do what you need to do to attract if that person wants you or not, baby. All right? Because sometimes we want things that ain't wanting us. But if you're in alignment and you're doing what you're supposed to do, you're going to attract the right love for you. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes we want things that ain't in alignment with us. You see what I'm saying? So, but if you is not doing what you're supposed to and you're not loving yourself, you're gonna attract a toxic person that don't love themselves. But whoever you are, beautiful diamonds, let you love yourself. We don't want to hold her hearts over here. Love and fearless always. You know what I'm saying? You get the victory, baby. I'm telling you. It's gonna get beautiful. Like, get ready, because that ugly energy that see, the more that they target people that's in divine love, the more upgrades we're going to love ourselves anymore. You know what I'm saying? They're helping us to see who we truly are soulfully. They're helping us to understand who we are on a God level. So, and they're going to have to learn too. Somebody got their twin flame. Somebody's balanced here. Somebody got some type of twin flame union love possibly just coming in. Look at this bottom of the deck. Blossom of abundance. It's because you chose to love yourself, because you balance the divine feminine, the divine masculine within. So within, so without. I always say that. Whoever you are, you're very balanced. We got master number 44 and 22 out here, okay? So you could be seeing 6-6 or 8 and 4. But something's coming in. You could be seeing 888-444, okay? Oh, it's going to be people that's brokenhearted, because something's coming to an end for somebody. Like, it's people that's gonna be brokenhearted because they're gonna see you in this energy. It could be I don't know why broken. Let's see why brokenhearted here. Oh yeah, somebody gonna be brokenhearted because somebody is trying to figure out what decision or direction they're going in. Whatever direction you go in or whatever, somebody's feeling lost. Whoever was trying to slow down this victory for whoever this woman holding her heart is, who's meant for this daughter, person, healing and happiness, whose life is vibrant and positive, these people are broken heart because they couldn't cause you to be indecisive. And now because they did all this, it's like since the fall times, these people been going into eerie. You see the eeriness of those woods? It's like no matter what direction they go in, it's going to be eerie for them. It's the unknown. Okay? And they're going to be brokenhearted. This happened for somebody the 8th year, during this 2024, the 8th year. Okay? They did too much during the fall. I'm like, the fall was the last go run for them. This unhappy ass family. They're going to be brokenhearted. Because you're going to have it all. They tried to stop you. They tried to hinder you. They tried to end you. They tried to dead you. They tried to do all kinds of things to the beautiful diamonds of light. And now you about to have all this success and this victory. And they're going to be brokenhearted because they can't come along with you. And they had a chance to just love you, support you, be there for you. And they chose not to do these things. Now they're going to be waddling in their own sorrow. Not so happy. But that's the choices they made. It's about you being happy. They need to go. They just going to have to heal. They got to go through these things so they can heal. It's something that they was trying to do by isolating you. This is something to do with financial gain. It's something, this right here, the garden holder, the gate, is like somebody was trying to keep you from going out to obtain what was meant for you. Now they're finna be stuck in this energy. And they're mad and they're brokenhearted because they couldn't have you isolated. They couldn't keep you isolated. Even when you was in this gate, you see all the flowers and all the plants, the beauty around. It's like you even created beauty when you was isolated. They thought isolating you was going to hold you back. It made you check more into who you are. They thought that you was going to be unhappy by not being able to venture out. Like I was saying earlier, yeah, I've been in the house for days. I've been chilling. You know what I'm saying? I ain't not done. Ain't nothing I really can do. I've been chilling. I'm happy in the house. I'm good. You know what I'm saying? They thought that isolating you and keeping you in there, you weren't going to be able to venture out. They thought that it was going to keep you depressed and down and out. But you turned lemon into lemonade, like they say. You know what I'm saying? You made the best of it. And now you're about to go out. You come. You about to get your daughter back.
It's back out here.
There go all these doors. Somebody, boy, we about to be popping here 2024. Hey, 2024. Hey. Party over here. Okay. So, that's because you chose to do the work. You chose to heal yourself. You manifested this for yourself. All right. You stayed true to you. You said, fuck what they said, fuck what they heard. And you was like, I'm doing me. I don't care about what nobody else doing. They can be doing all the... And you chose that no matter what, this unhappy family was doing, whoever else was doing, that you was going to love yourself and still continue to love them regardless, even if it's from a distance. You don't hate nobody. I don't hate nobody. So because of this, it's a lot that's about to come in. Whatever this fortune is, whatever this, what they were trying to keep you from having, you're going after it. You obtained it. You even obtained it while you was in here. They wanted to create a monster. They wanted to create a monster. Sometimes when you try to create a monster, that monster, boy. Oh, somebody here, a man holding his heart in reverse. A romantic love, this could be an ex, honey. Somebody's brokenhearted. Or they could have been... Somebody want to cage you in, cage your heart or something. They could have been targeting your love life. Confirmation, but excuse me. Yeah, they were targeting your love life. They wanted whoever this person that you supposed to be with or whoever you with or supposed to be with or was with. They did a lot to his heart to make this person see you in a different way. Even though you was just love here, he didn't see you as that because a lot of people was... You know, he was your daughter romance, but he didn't see you that. He didn't see you as, or you his daughter romance, but he didn't see you as that because it was a lot of things being, you know, projected out to him. He might have been listening to the wrong people or something. Yeah, like they was trying to tell him, she not for you or he not for you or whatever, okay? They this, they that, like, and they don't even really know you. Like, they don't even know who know what you need for you but you. Especially when you grown. Y'all had y'all chance to nurture us and raise us in a certain way. Y'all messed up. And because they didn't even have the nurturing that they need, and because they didn't follow their own hearts, after their own hearts, they wanted to try to make sure the ones that they supposed to have ushered up did the same thing. It's like that generational curse, that same cycle. But a lot of us came out of those cycles. We was like, we finna be like them people. And a lot of us had to leave them people behind. And leave them people alone. And whoever's sending me some negative eye, you know, you better check yourself before you wreck yourself. Because I feel that energy. I don't receive it. I send you love. I send whoever it is love. Do something with your energy. Do something with that hate. Whatever you got going on with you. If you got a problem with viewing in with my motherfucking page, check the fuck up off of here. Okay? Get on up off of here, because coming in looking at me in a fucked up way, your whole world gonna get turned upside down because you projecting something that I don't deserve. Because I don't hate you. I don't hate nobody. I do love. But what I'm not gonna receive is these people out here hate anymore. So I'm telling you, there's gonna be some strong boundaries energetically set here. This force field is shit gonna go boom. It's literally gonna blow you out your seat. So stop. Don't nobody deserve that shit because y'all don't love y'all selves. Go find something safe to do. If you don't like me I want to be on my channel. I want to see me some negative energy. Go on ahead and go smoke or do whatever you do and fall in your own little world, baby, because this ain't the world you want to be in. This ain't the world you want to be in. No, you don't want these problems. I got 99 problems and evolving ain't one. So you can't stop that. So get out my lane. Get out my energy. Matter of fact, I cashed you out. Somebody got some cornucopia coming. So, it's a daughter value here. And it's a man here. a romantic love here, okay? This romantic love, this man holding his heart could be a father figure or could be an ex-love. This person could be in, like, some type of energy with this unhappy family. Now, this is somebody in your family, whether it's a father, an uncle, or whoever, this masculine, or it could be an ex-love because it is beside romance. Like I said, they could have been trying to target your romance, all right? Because they know that this romance is what's going to help together y'all can have this cornucopia, all right? But whatever the case, somebody could be coming out of a relationship that's toxic too, okay? But, and you're going into some type of true romance, okay? Into your cornucopia, like who you with might not be, or who you love wasn't the person with you. This could be somebody else, or some healing coming, okay? Maybe somebody no longer want to be brokenhearted and they doing some healing. Whatever the case, if you've been doing the work, you're going to attract who and what is meant for you, because you're meant to have this, so you're going to have this. So if you're in something toxic or something that ain't been in alignment, that person going to either get in alignment so he or she can match your energy. Or if they're not willing to, that energy is going to be pushed aside and you're going to walk into something new, all right? Something authentic, something true, something real, okay? But like I said, also I did break because I said your unhappy family was targeting your union, making somebody family, was making them feel some type of way, whether it's a masculine or feminine, some type of way about you that wasn't true. And maybe they finally seeing the light. Maybe they finally seeing you in this light. Maybe they finally realizing they want to have this, they want to come out of this cage and unlock their heart and let you love them and love you the way you're supposed to, so y'all can obtain this cornucopia together. Just take what resonates, okay? What else? Oh, boy, look at this. Somebody about to, y'all about to have a world, baby. Baby, baby. Ooh, baby, baby. Salt and Pepper's Hill. Okay, so listen. This is beautiful. Somebody's about to have it all. Somebody is on their way. Baby, you got so much coming in. Like, one beautiful thing after another, and nobody cannot stop it. We already know you got a victory because you love yourself. You've done the work, all right? You obtained the knowledge. You went through major transformation, death, and rebirth. And I keep saying, the more these people try to throw this death magic and this negative energy, they're just powering us up. Appreciate it. You're coming out of this financial constraint. A lot of you probably like me, been having a lot of financial problems because people been throwing energy at your finances, doing a lot of finance management. Like, they've been trying to keep you isolated and stop your finances from coming, because this is a financial card itself. So they've been trying to stop your finances from coming in. But baby, it's raining money over here. Okay? Literally. This daughter value. You're about to come into this financial game. You're coming out of this financial constraints. No more struggling. You know what I'm saying? It's time for you to obtain this cornucopia. Okay? My daughter said, no more struggling. We got this Karen connection in reverse. This could be an ex or something like that. Something with your Karen connection. The Karen connection could be family too. Excuse me as I say that. Yeah. They've been doing magic, whoever this is. Like I said, this family could have been doing magic towards your Karen connection. All this Karen connection is doing some type of, either way, it's some magic at play here. Somebody definitely playing in the magic. Yeah, they've been strategically still trying. But to no avail, they're still trying. Because people don't want you to win, but you already got the victory. Like I told you, like these winter months, you might feel this energy a little bit, but you got this force field that's getting stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger and stronger. Okay? And that energy going quickly, even it's going like it was hitting them a little bit, like it was hitting you more this past year, right? But it wasn't hitting you like it's supposed to. But some of it was showing up, put it like that. Some of it was showing up. And they thought because some of them were showing up, they was getting away with it. But then it was like, well, damn, why this ain't work? Wait a minute now. Hold up. Wait, this person still, Didn't know you was the Matrix on their ass. Like, for real. So, they still kept doing it. They still kept doing it because they thought because some of them were showing up that it was going to succeed. Like, to no avail, though. But it's like, okay, during December, January, and February, like, you might have been feeling a little bit of this energy. And you feeling it less and less. And it's going back to them a little quicker. I'm telling you. Come March, you're not going to feel none of this energy. You're going to be all into this. This is where you're going to be at. You're going to be all into this corn cup. But they're still trying to do magic. Okay? This caring connection. Because they're afraid. They know what you're walking into. They know what you're obtaining. This unhappy family and stuff. They know that this is destined for you. So what are they doing? They're still trying. But I'm telling you, the closer it get, the more we come out of these winter months, that magic gonna go back to them even faster to the point it's not even gonna hit you at all. It's gonna knock people on their ass. Yeah, this is a thinking woman in reverse. This gonna be somebody's mother, auntie, just, you know, some old toxic person, whatever they thinking about doing with this magic, whatever they thinking about doing. Negative. Yeah, they can be targeting your caring connection. You could be having problems in your caring connection. Like I say, this somebody was targeting this masculine energy or somebody in this energy to because they did not want this person or y'all to be together. But you show strength. The angel of strength is here. Something is strong. This is a strong union I'm getting. Whoever doing this magic though is going to backfire. That's why she's in reverse. This could be a caring connection doing this too, like a couple. Maybe this is these two. Take what resonates. All right? They don't really love each other, and whatever they've been thinking of coming up together to do to somebody, it's not working. It's like bloop-a-da-bloop. It's like the blop of blooper. Sorry, troopers. Could be some police officers. Somebody working law enforcement, because I said, sorry, trooper. That's a damn shame. Yeah, it is. It's always a shame. It's a shame on them. I feel for them. Because they don't get it. What else? Yeah, they're trying to get you to walk away, baby. They don't want this couple to stay together. Are they trying to get you to walk away from what's meant for you? They want you to stop moving forward. They want you to stop. They want you to give up on yourself. They want you to stop fighting. That's why they're doing so much magic. They figure if they do enough magic, then, you know, you eventually walk away and give up. No, bitches. You all better walk away. You've been guided to walk away from doing this. Okay? Yeah, they want you to think about walking away. I'm getting, okay, so the magic is towards this caring connection. Take what resonates, right? And they want you to think about walking away from whoever this masculine is, because he might not have been showing, or feminine, take what resonates, might not have been showing you the love that you need, because they ain't been loving themselves because magic has been done, okay? And whatever you're doing, you could be thinking about walking away because they're projecting, they're doing magic towards... It could be making him think about walking away. Whatever the case, somebody is throwing some magic here to cause a separation. They want somebody to be brokenhearted. Maybe somebody is trying to make a decision here. Yeah, look, Archangel Michael is here. Whatever this is, it's going to be stable. Like, people have been trying to... It's not in reverse, so Archangel... Michael is here protecting this. Whatever this is. Whatever this is, it's going to stay stable. It's going to be stable. It's going to become stable. All right? Because he's here fighting for this. This person, though, whoever this person is, they do operate in their root chakra. Yeah, the hostilities. You see the swords? This thinking woman. This is somebody, mother, grandmother, auntie, or something like that. Somebody's been targeting a caring connection. This person, love, I've been feeling a lot of hostility. This person is hostile. Whoever this person is don't love themselves. They don't want their son, daughter, niece, grand, whoever to be happy. This woman don't want somebody to be happy. Whatever they're creating, though, could be talking your creativity, or this person, whatever they're trying to come up with creatively, whatever they're thinking of, it ain't gonna match. Yeah, somebody's coming to speak some type of truth here about something. Or maybe you speak a lot of truth. Got a lot of angels here. A lot of angels showing up. Dang, angels done came out back to back. You got Archangel Ariel here, Gabriel, and Michael. Ooh, somebody is... Ooh, so somebody come to speak something. Maybe this is something to do with an ex-love. I don't know. But this person is losing their coins to love you with. Maybe he come to speak about something. Maybe it's something he know. Maybe he's he's indecisive, like whether he should leave, whether he should stay, whether she should leave, whether she should stay, because it's magic. Somebody's torn on their finances. Somebody's torn on their thoughts. Somebody's really fucking this man holding. Somebody's messing him up bad. Somebody's really targeting whoever this energy is. Or this is a caring connection doing this because they know you thinking about walking away and they don't want you to. Take what resonates. Well, shit, if you don't want somebody to walk away, you better do right by them. Love yourself. Do right by yourself. Love yourself, and you ain't got to worry about nobody walking away from you, baby. Don't nobody want to stand no mess. Because whoever this is, whoever this woman holding her heart is, okay, whoever in that energy, they got cornucopia and true romance in alignment here. Like, you meant for real love. Yeah, this is, you meant real love. You about to have it all with whoever this is. If he's not doing right, if he's the one doing this magic, okay, and he trying to get you from, to stop you from thinking about walking away, I'm getting to, somebody could be doing magic to try to confuse you, bring you confused and illusion so you won't walk away from them. But see, you appreciate it. Your ancestors and guides are here rewarding you with all this stuff. So if this person... Whether it's a couple doing this, whether it's somebody in a union you doing this to, or whether somebody doing this to a union, whoever doing this, they're not going to succeed because this woman's holding her heart is meant to have all that she's meant to have, and she's going to have it with who she's supposed to have it with. Or whether it's a masculine, divine feminine, take what resonates, you're meant to have it all. So whatever these people are conjuring up, whatever this happy, unhappy family is, this lover, ex-lover, whatever these people are stirring up in their little blah, 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 pot, their little shits, pot, it's just gonna get flushed down the toilet. It ain't gonna matter. It ain't gonna work. Yeah, something moving forward here. It ain't gonna, somebody's taking them, somebody could be walking away from something. Yeah, because it's balance here. Something gotta be balanced out energetically, okay? Whatever was put in a jar, I'm getting, you see how she's looking in this angel like, oh, you thought you were going to put my baby in here, huh? So this is somebody's ancestor. Somebody's ancestor say, you thought you were going to put my baby in this jar? Nah, we're going to go ahead and take care of this. We're going to put your ass in here. Huh? You going in this jar. Nah, you see? That's why I say people start playing because they're going to fuck around right now. Why they keep doing this to themselves? What's wrong with them, Lord? Ooh. Yeah. I'm telling you, this could be a couple. I got earlier these troubles. This could be some type of authority figures. I'm telling you. Both of them, whoever these people is, they broke. They if they ain't, they about to leave. They about to lose it all. Oof, whoever this caring connection is, I don't know. Somebody here, whoever this is. Y'all know it'd be a lot of different people in my energy, so I... confirmation, bro, excuse me. So, hey, if you resonate with this, they don't know what to do. They all unhealed, okay? Yeah. Call back your energy, because like I say, it's a group of people. It's a community of people. It'd be a lot of people, but spirits say access denied, bitches. Y'all better let go of these attachments. I'm trying to destroy people's lives. I'm telling you what I know. Like, it's not gonna... baby, we walking into new divine energies. Like, it's just time for the tables to turn. Like, it's time for everybody to heal. And that's what I want. I want people to just start loving themselves, yo. I'm like, well, since I'm right there, let's get this magical dimensional orca activation there. Let's see what's going on. Let's pull some more energy. Yep, they can get it. They can get gone. Yeah, they need to get gone. They're gonna get gone. I wait, left my ass deep down inside, huh? Oh, you can wait on wood, baby. Let's see what's going on. Uh-oh. Got celestial assistance here. Yeah. Somebody creativity. Oh, somebody need to let go of something. Whatever they're trying to create. Oh, trying to cause some type of disconnection. Okay. All right. So illusions of disconnection, trying to cause somebody to be exiled or something here. Somebody need to stop. I'm telling you, these people keep getting warned of whatever they're doing. It's a storm coming because it looks like it's about to rain outside out of nowhere. Look, this popped back out. See, there's some type of enlightenment. You got your celestial sin, your guardians, your angels here. Somebody is an earth angel. You see this? Somebody could have native ancestors. It's something that they're doing here. All right. In the ethereal realms, in the higher realms, they're taking care of something. They're reconforming something. Okay? They're placing so... what they showing me this angel right here doing? It's like people doing stuff, but this angel in the ethereal realms is changing shit like magically. Like it's gonna make it look like it. So people been lying and reconfiguring, making stuff look a way that it don't supposed to look. Like they've been doing energy work, all right, spell work to make things illusions. Right, that's what I'm getting, some type of illusion, confusion. But your ancestors, the angel, right, they're like, nope. Let's put this back where it's supposed to go, because these motherfuckers think this a game. Matter of fact, let's put their asses over here. Something. Negative, boss. They're like, nah, we ain't letting them do that. We already got this shit in the bag. Let's go ahead and... Every time they think they making moves, you got your celestial scissors here like, nah, what you think you're doing? Where you going with that? Nah, bitch. Let me put you... Yeah, they think they're doing stuff and they not. Yeah, because your manifestations meant to come in, baby. Yeah. It's time. It's bring the money. You got a whole lot of money in the... Mm-mm. So somebody do have fortune coming in, prosperity, you manifesting this, okay? Your angels, the one I'm seeing, somebody was trying to stop this. Whatever this fortune is, whatever's meant for you, we're playing around, trying to finagle some stuff energetically, and they were like... Ah. What you doing? And I got it. If they don't stop, they're going to be on the bottom of this plane. Somebody having a breakthrough, new beginnings. I'm telling you. I just, listen. They can't stop it. They can't stop your victory, baby. They can't slow it down no more. It's done. The dark agenda is over. It's done. Not in the middle. Yeah, your celestials, the angels are here making sure you get this. Whatever this is, they're bringing this in. We're gonna have some freedom here, finally. Okay, the numbers 529 and 4 could be significant. Another spirit. Oh, they wanna be specific. Okay, well, dang. Uh-oh, somebody better let go of doing some this magic. I'm telling you, they're going to have to let go, release, like, I don't like to say release, when you release, you bring something back to you, but letting go is up here, okay? Somebody's going to have to let go of doing this magic. You also got it to make sure you're doing your cleansing and stuff too, okay? Because they are sending a lot of magic. We have to stay on top of that, okay? Because whatever they did, whatever they thought they was doing with these blocks and challenges, no, it's not working. Why I say your confirmation burp, excuse me, your ancestors and Ethereum, like, nope. What you think you're doing, bitch? Blocked. Blocked. You still playing? Okay. Don't fuck around and find out. Woo. Ain't that funny? Somebody gonna have to deal with look, reflect the truth. You gonna have to have some acceptance, baby. Somebody having to take a look at themselves in the mirror. All right, somebody and whatever they sending that somebody could be doing some type of identity theft, all right, here, or trying to destiny swap or some shit like that, some twin energies. Okay, whatever they're doing, they're gonna have to take a look in the mirror. and be like, listen, I better get it together. This ain't looking too good. It ain't panning out right for me. We need to leave this alone. Like, for real, because this energy gonna backfire. Because they're not playing, okay? Whatever magic they doing here, whatever this magic magician is, whatever they're trying to emerge this up, whatever they're trying to create, whatever they're trying to create to bring you this energy is not coming to you, all right? Yeah, baby, you're right. You got protection. All, damn right, we got protection all around us. But if you ain't doing, listen, make sure you ain't the one that's doing the stuff. Because if you doing anything towards anybody like that, baby, you ain't got no protection. Because they're not protecting this mess no more. I'm just telling you. Not saying that to you, baby. I hope you are. I'm not saying that it happened to you. But a lot of people be saying that. They be thinking that they could do this negative stuff. They just having me say this to people. And they protect it from the shit coming back to them. No, fuck it ain't. Not saying that about you because I don't know you. But I'm just saying. They're just telling me to say that. Yeah. The light is about to be shined on something here. Somebody got to have some acceptance. All right, whatever they were trying to manipulate here, that they can't. Things are being centered and balanced out. Cause like I say, you have pure intentions. You about to have this breakthrough. Your manifestations is coming again. The angels and celestial beings are here, making sure that whatever these people are trying to manifest here is not gonna work. Yeah, somebody coming to speak something. Somebody coming to shine the light on something. Somebody coming to speak some type of truth because they're looking at the mirror like, oh, no, wait a minute. Hold up. This shit coming back on us. They trying to come up out this karma because they realizing that, like I say, they can't stop it. You know, they can't stop it. You did all this to try to damn somebody else's dreams and it could be acquiring energy, okay? Or this coming out this winter, during these winter months. Okay, somebody had to do some self-analysis, right? But they're coming to shine a light on. Somebody coming to speak some truth this winter. Whether this is Aquarius energy, Ice Queen, or just during this winter, or somebody that did some intro. They took a look at themselves. They look at themselves in the mirror and be like, somebody don't like the way they're looking right now. Again, whoever this was did a lot of beauty magic too, because y'all know they be trying to tag my ass. But I'm beautiful anyway, baby. Hey, my heart is beautiful. You can tag anything on the outside, baby. Inside is full of motherfucking luxury and beauty and love and enlightenment. This is what my inside look like. This. Vibrant. So whatever you're trying to do on the outside, it won't matter. That stuff don't move me. Because I know I'm loving here. So, but somebody come to speak something. Yeah, they want you to trust them. Okay? Whoever this is having to overcome some type of doubts and insecurities. Yeah. If something is going to happen at night, this person could be trying to call you at nighttime. Okay. Maybe they're scared about some type of transformation that's coming here. Ooh, see. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. Y'all ready for this? Your patience, baby, because you trust. Because you, because whoever you are, divine feminine and divine masculine out there, because you did self-analysis. Because you waited to a point in time and you was patient. And even though all of this stuff was going on with you, even though all this magic was being thrown at you, you came against all these blocks and challenges. You came out of this energy. You did not let this energy affect you. You chose to do self-love here, okay? That's why your ancestors, the angels, and guides are protecting you and making sure you have these manifestations coming in, okay? That's why you're about to have this breakthrough, this new breakthrough energy, this new beginning, okay? And this new beginning, because you trust and you have faith. You was patient. During these winter months, after this winter, I told y'all, March or something like that, you going into this, baby. For real, for real. This is beautiful, like, somebody, we about to be doing it up. You know what I'm saying? I'm getting big boss moves. Like, something really finna start coming in for the beautiful ones that's been in alignment and doing the work. Like, this is all year. This is all time. No, I didn't. I always told them. This is all time. Oh, maybe tell somebody else. You know, somebody had to let go of some attachments. Okay? Whoever this was trying to hold on to, trying to stop you.
All right, somebody was scared of allowing you to. Somebody was afraid, or don't be afraid of this, or something like that. Whatever this is a lot of money. Whatever this is, it's gonna like stuff you never experienced. This is like something you never experienced before in your life. Like this is like a whole new world. That's what I'm getting. We hear that all the time, right? So it's like, don't be scared of it. Let go of the attachment. Don't be scared of like that. This ain't for me. Let go of the attachment. You don't deserve this because you do. Like a lot of us, we want stuff. We manifest stuff, and then it be stuff. And when it comes to us, we'll shy away from it or we'll push it away. Or you know what I'm saying? Like spirits that don't do that. Know that this is for you. You'll know it is, but you know it's coming. But whoever was trying to do magic to stop this too, that's who's gonna have to let go of these attachments. Yeah. Somebody not getting some type of clarity. They was trying to hold on to this, whoever this was. They were trying to block you from seeing this too, kind of cause confusions. Somebody was trying to make you scared to walk into this. Like I said, it's that walking away again. It's like that energy, like doing spell work to make you, you know, magic done showed up twice. So the magician came in the last deck in this one. So somebody definitely been trying to do magic to make you scared of walking into the success, walking into this livelihood, walking into this new lifestyle, walking into this abundance, walking into all these doors. They was trying to make you scared of yourself. They was trying to make you doubt yourself. But spirits say it's coming because you overcame your doubts and insecurities. Now this utopia is coming. Because you stood up, you was like, nah, I'm going to get this. Nah, this ain't me. I know what I want. And you went out and you manifested this, baby. Don't drop it though. It's for you. Yeah. Oh boy. There's some type of disconnect here. Oh, I'm getting you about to come out of this. You see this red door? You transform. You like, I'm walking away, I'm flying, I'm getting out of all this negativity. You had to disconnect yourself from all this negativity, all these low vibrational doors. Like you leaving all that behind. You closing the door on that negative, those negative people placing the thing. You're like, nope, I'm transforming, I'm evolving, I'm going to the higher realms. I'm using my divine knowledge. I'm going into my higher self. You are. You chose to do the right thing. You chose to come up out of this energy and you closed the door on it. You're like, I'm not looking back either. They can have, now you about to get your roses. This your ancestors right here. All right. They're watching you. This is them in the spiritual realm. You see the fairies and stuff? This is a loved one that passed on. This is your the ethereal, like fairy angels and stuff like that, right? They're watching you energetically doing this. And they're giving you your roses. That's why they're watching you evolve into the highest version of yourself. And they're about to crown you. You're about to be crowned in the spiritual realm. You already been crowned. Somebody already, victory. You already got the victory. Like they can't take you off this pedestal energetically. Like you're there. It's nothing they can do. Anybody that try to pull on your energy to try to bring you back down to this low vibration. No, the door closed. They can't. They can't pull you down if they wanted to. They're going to end up dragging themselves down, trying to drag you down. Okay? You already got your mind made up, baby, because you're an inspirational creator. You always alchemize this. Every time they try to also try to exile you. Every time they try to exile you, maybe do this death magic or something like they be doing on me all the time, right? You just alchemize it and you evolve. Like I say, your ancestors and stuff watch you evolve and you're being crowned because every time they target you, you just alchemize. You're a great alchemist. And you do it with your inspiration, your inspirational success within your own well-being. They've been watching you and cheering you on. I'm hearing a bunch of claps and, you know, cheers. They just all, yay, our baby did it. I'm serious. They celebrating. What sign is it? It's not no sign. What you mean sign? Like a horoscope or something? It's all signs, baby. It's all signs. Whatever sign you want it to be. I'm a sign. I'm a water sign. Look, the divine feminine. Majestic eminence. You know your worth. You're coming out of all this negative energy, baby. You transmuted all this.
You transmuted all of this. Every time they sent you that negative, you like, eh, no. There you go. Y'all can have it back. It ain't mine. I ain't asked for it. I know you mad. Keep it moving. You just kept throwing it. Every time they sent you this negative shit, you like, oh, I feel it, but. It's yours. I'm telling you, every time they did it, you like, baby, I know my worth. I know who I am. What y'all think this is? Y'all think it's a game? Nah. Yeah, y'all can have it. Y'all want me to be in this energy. It might seem like I'm in it, but let me show y'all how I do it. Jump off me. Thank you. Uh-oh, look at this shit here. Divine masculine, divine feminine. This is for all divine beings out there. Know your worth, your balance. True love. Y'all hear that? It's raining. It's raining. Purification is taking place, all right? Yeah, no more of this negative energy, baby. Look at this divine master, divine feminine. Y'all doing it, baby. Y'all finna do it big. Do it big then. Earth angels. Earth angels. Earth angel warriors. Y'all fucked them up. Every time they try to come at y'all, y'all like, ah. Y'all messed them up. Y'all like, what y'all thought this was? Somebody been fighting hard for them in their life and their well-being and their success and their union, their divinity. Like, you've been fighting real hard. They literally fucked around and found out when they came into your energy that you about that. That you about that life. You don't just talk about you, feel about it. You're exactly who you say you are. Everybody doubt it, though. Some of them still doubt. Others see. Yeah, you awaken. There's some type of connection here, baby. Look, look. This love is this right here. Some you awakening to this connection. This is divine connection, baby. This is ancient. This is some past life stuff. This is an ancient connection. This soul right here, this divine masculine and divine feminine, ancient. Confirmation verb. Excuse me. y'all ancient. Y'all here to set the record straight, baby. Y'all gonna show them how it's done and what it do. And how it's true to it. Like, it's true to life. True to life, true to who y'all are, true to love, true to... And like, y'all true about yourselves. Y'all true to each other. Y'all gonna be... Ooh, this gonna be a powerful dynamic. This right here, baby. Ooh, this is strong love here. Both of y'all could be... There go that native. Somebody's native, too. All right. They go that native coming up again. Y'all got native ancestors, all right? Fairies. Y'all got tigers. Lions and tigers and bears. But I'm scared of loving you. They say I'm not scared of lions and tigers and bears, but they've been scared of loving you, baby, but they ain't scared no more. They ain't scared no more, baby. They said they want to co-create. Both of y'all magical. Both of y'all very powerful and magical. All right? Y'all here to co-create together. Both of y'all have a lot of confidence. Like, y'all powerful. Look, look, y'all see this castle back there? This y'all castle. You see that? Y'all see that? That's y'all palace. That's what y'all have. Y'all getting this utopia. Yeah, y'all co-creating to build this kingdom. All right? Yeah. This is beautiful. Mushrooms can be very soon. There's something about mushrooms here. I keep saying that's the way of the future. Like, shit, maybe that's some of y'all. Oh, some of y'all. How are you telling me this? The mushroom kingdom is... Y'all part of something to do with the mushroom kingdom. Something about your DNA or something like that. And then that's the way of the future, too. I'm getting like, that's like, I was telling my lover that that's going to be, y'all know how we have all kind of meats on the shelves. Like, it's going to be like all kind of mushrooms to choose from. People really finna go take mushroom to another level, like, cause they already doing it. Like, that's gonna be like the meat base. Like, anyway, what is this? Stop playing. Oh. They do what they gotta do. Listen, y'all don't get this. Do y'all see this shit? I can't make this up. Somebody was trying to cause an illusion of separation between a divine union, and y'all about to do it. How you do that, damn? This come from the start. I told y'all ancient. Y'all galactic. What? They ain't ready. Oh my goodness, this is beautiful. The color blue could be significant. Y'all definitely from the stars, baby. Somebody's star family. Wow. I'm impressed with this. Let it be. What do? Maybe that's me and my union. I don't know. Lord, look. Y'all went through, both of y'all went through major transformations. Y'all went through a lot. Both of y'all went through metamorphosis. Like, whatever this is, the pressure made the damn diamonds for real. The pressure made the diamonds. Yeah. Y'all are crystal beings. Like, y'all, both of y'all went through major transformation. Now the unexpected is about to happen. Why is it trans? Let me see why that's here. Let's see, why is this here? Oh man, look at this. Unity. Confirmation, bro. Excuse me. Listen, somebody's about to okay, so this is as a whole, like this is divine masculine, divine feminine is like coming together. Like this is gonna be powerful couples, like for real. Like people that done their work attracting like each other, like mag, like it's gonna happen. Like it's something that's like a lot of energy and magic was done to separate these true divine unions. Like this has been going on for lifetimes. Like y'all been fighting for this moment right here for lifetimes. Like y'all been fighting. Now it's a higher perspective. Like this moon energy is not even able to be pulled off of from a negative perspective anymore. The moon is here to brain balance. Like it's because the feminine energy is healing, right? So because of the feminine energy is healing, because mind you, as long as women are toxic, men gonna continue to be away, because a lot of us are raising these children. So but it's like the coming together, right? So it's like the divine masculine, divine families, or families coming together to raise divine families, and like that's gonna continue, so we can go into this higher perspective of this new world, okay? So it's healing. Everything that's When these full moons come around, or these cycles come around, okay, people can no longer pull off this energy negatively no more, because it's here for a higher perspective, okay? This is here, we're here for unity. So this is what that's what that is, a metamorphosis. Both of y'all, both of these energies in the world has went through major metamorphosis, death and rebirth, like death and rebirth. And now these unions are about to come together and make this world a better place. Yes, honey. I love this. I can't. It's destined. It's destined, baby. Destiny. Man, listen. If you've been putting in the work and you've been waiting on your divine masculine, divine feminine, have you been in a relationship and y'all been having trouble, baby, because magic and stuff? Like it's gonna be some healing taking place, okay? Are you gonna come into a connection with your divine master, divine feminine? It's just time, like, because it's time for us to set the record straight. It's just time for the higher perspective. It's just the tables has turned. It's time for us to heal. We've healed. We're gonna heal and grow together. It's just the time. It's beautiful. Like I love this. It's for the divine purpose. I can't with this. Y'all, this is beautiful. That's what that breakthrough is, the new beginnings. This is the new beginnings to the new earth. Just trust it. All right. Just trust it. Don't be doubting it. Don't be doubting when that person come along. You be like, nah, that ain't them. You know what I'm saying? You ain't gonna feel that way anymore because you gonna know. You gonna be like, listen, I'm in alignment, baby. I know what I'm attracting. Shit, this it. I ain't selling it for nothing else. God, you ain't bringing me no mess when I done did all this motherfucking work right here. You gonna be able to see it. You like, ain't no toxic energy or no negative, no karmic masculine or feminine gonna be able to come into your energy. They just not. Because you're gonna be able to see right through them and read them like a book. A lot of toxic people are gonna be afraid to come around divine beings because we can see them. See what I'm saying? So it's gonna be this person gonna be loyal, hardworking, truthful, dedicated. They're gonna love themselves. The only reason they're gonna be loyal to you because they're loyal to themselves, baby. That's how we be loyal to other people, because we're loyal to who we are. That's where true loyalty lies. If you're loyal to yourself, you're gonna be loyal to the next person because you only respecting and loving who you are. You know your value and your worth. You're not gonna settle for less. See what I'm saying? So you're attracting that. Okay? This is beautiful. Oh yeah. It's all right that you're not for everyone. You're not meant to be for everyone, okay? See a dragonfly. Oh, I love you too. Let's see what's going on. Oh, the light just came on outside. Y'all see me look like somebody up there? That's up a little hotter now. I don't even know what that was. So the light is about to be shine, like it's about to get bright. And it's two lights. It's like it's a light side by side. Both of y'all finna shine bright like a diamond. I'm telling y'all coming together. Who is who? Who is what? Are you talking to me? Who is it? Oh no, it's just a night light. Like, you know, the lights, the sensors that come on. All paths lead to home. Trust your intuition. You're being led to the place you need to. I know it's been like a maze, all right? It's been a lot of force fields around. You see this? You see the force field? Something was trying to keep... Someone was trying to keep y'all out, to keep you out from going to where you're supposed to be. But it's like now that you have your inner authority... You trust your intuition, you're gonna know how to get through that. Matter of fact, when you get close to that force field, it's gonna have to your command. You're gonna be like, you're gonna tell it to disappear, and it's gonna disappear. That's how much power you have. Okay, you control that. You control the force fields around you now. Surrender, rock, crack wide open. Oh, okay. Let's see what this somebody be cracked wide open here. Somebody could be about to hit rock bottom. Who tried to hit me in my motherfucking face? Somebody say, I'm sorry. Remember when we was picking on that unhappy family in reverse earlier in the read? Yeah, they want to come and apologize because they hitting rock bottom. Because these people, this people from home, okay? Somebody's sorry for what they did. This could be two people. Somebody's praying. Whatever they did, like this, you see these roots? I'm getting all this root work that they did, this magic or whatever they did to try to bury you, bury your situation, bury your union, whatever this case is. These two people, they're afraid that they're about to get buried or something like that. Whatever they're doing, they're trying to ground their energy and they want to apologize because somebody's wanting to surrender here. Yeah. But something about because things are being woven. Just wait, though. Or somebody's waiting to do it. They slowing it up. Like, they're procrastinating. This could be like a love. Your love. Mm-hmm. Somebody needs to surrender the sweetness. Okay, so whenever this person comes in, like, whether this family or whatever the case, just don't be mean to them. Like, if you decide to talk to them, because a lot of us got like strong boundaries, like we ain't trying to hear nothing. But some of these people want to say they're sorry because they need that type of they need you to forgive. They need to hear that you forgive them so that they can move on and heal or some stuff like that. Spirit say this: if they do reach out, if you do happen to talk to them, just, you know, shower them with love.
Tell them that's okay, move on. So, but if it's something that's meant to be rekindled, it was. But just say Venus here. So we got love here. So somebody sorry, all right. Somebody ready to surrender. This could be your union though, because I'm looking at like two people. Here goes still this love energy. You see this man and this woman here? You see how he over there? She's sitting over here on the land, all dressed up, and he in the water purifying himself. He had to go clean. He had to go clean. He had to go clean his energy. He was like, wait a minute, let me get this right. She gonna leave me. She gonna leave me. Or he gonna leave me behind. Take what resonates. Let me go do it. So this person, whoever this is, they want to apologize because whoever they is, realizing that they didn't do right by you. You deserve more. Maybe they had to go through their dark night of the soul. This is something to do with love here. I'm getting again. This is to help bring in a new earth. I can't say it, but so many times. You talking about little Stanky. I don't know who little Stanky is. Y'all must be talking to each other. They ain't even really chiming in. But whoever you are, y'all meant to bring golden children in this world. You could be the golden child, okay? Whoever you are innocent. You have rare gifts, okay? You're here to help bring in a new earth. And you actually been loving on yourself. You're full of joy and pleasure, okay? You're about to walk into some great victories. You really are, baby, because you're the child of the cosmos, baby. You are the embodiment of soul creator God. Like, you carry it all, great intelligence. That's why, and you have rare gifts. You very talented, you're very unique. All right. Wherever you go, you bring a lot of energy and power to these places. That's why I say, like, wherever you led to certain places here, whoever you are, you're so powerful, and then you're gonna command. Like, you see these energies, this like force fields that's up trying to stop you from getting somewhere or trying to stop other people from getting out. It's like you're about to free these people. Okay? You're about to free these people because your energy is gonna speak to this or whatever power, however powerful you are. You bring power to certain places. You activate the earth. You activate certain places. All right, because you connect this to the earth. So because you connect this to the earth, when your energy moves to certain places, you activate these places. You don't want to let down these force fields. All right, you don't want to set people free. You're here to do that. That's how you're bringing in this new earth. Happy New Year's. But spirits say trust when you are led it because you're about to travel. All right, somebody about to travel here soon. Yeah, because you hit a pain. My nose is itching. Somebody is here to be the w leader that they wish they had. You're here to lead the new earth. You're here to lead by leading yourself. You're here to pave the way to the new earth. You're here for the world, baby. I'm going to tell y'all quick, sir. Like, when I was about 8 to 10 years old, I remember looking in the mirror. I was looking at myself in the mirror. I was young, but I've always been kind of, intelligent, right? I've always had this unique cosmic, like I always thought outside the box, like I've always been different. Now I remember looking at myself in the mirror, and I looked at myself in the mirror and I say, this is not the real me. I say, the real me is looking through these eyes at that me. I say, but that's me too. And I said, me in there, why am I here looking through these eyes at this me? Why am I here as this me looking through these eyes? Because real me looking through these eyes. I asked myself this about 8, 10 years old, no lie. And the real me in here looking through these eyes, my soul said, you're here to help save the world. And I was like, oh. And I remember walking away and I never questioned. I don't know how I'm here to help save the world. I guess by saving myself from everything I done overcame, had to overcame and went through. You see what I'm saying? That's how you save the world, by saving yourself. Okay? But yeah, you're here to be a leader. You wish you had to pave the new path. All right? Diving deep, sharing your songs. Somebody could sing here, all right. Love to sing, all right. You meant to dive deep into something, dive deep into your emotions, dive deep into what's going on with the world, dive deep within your own well-being, okay? And as you dive deep within you, you're here to whatever you've healed through, whatever you overcame, you're here to express that, to be an example that to show other people how to do it, like do by you being you. You trigger other people. Like I said, you are this force field. Like you let down the
Your energy is so powerful that when you come into a certain vicinity or a certain place, you really break barriers. I'm getting, yeah. You break barriers and force fields. Okay? Yeah, testimony. Magnetic, yes. Okay, what else? Woo! Violet flame, baby. You're the blue flame. It's a lot of activations coming on. Okay, you're here to bring spontaneous awakening to people. Because you do things, so you, like I say, whoever you are, you got rare gifts. So you do things in a way that it brings spontaneous awakening to other people's minds. They're like, when they see you or see you do something, you do something, you're not afraid to do it. All right, because you're here to pave the new way. You're not afraid to be yourself. And so when people see you do something, they might think it's strange, but you had them thinking like, wait a minute, we can do that? What is that? What's she talking about? They might have heard something you said. They might go back and think about it later on. And then they'll start, God will start showing them things too in their own well-being. You know what I'm saying? They'll start, oh, you know what I'm saying? Are you awakening people to see them, that the things that they've been experiencing and going through, it's okay because there's people out there like that too. There's nothing wrong with you. You see what I'm saying? So you letting people know that it's okay to be them. It's all right to be strange. It's all right to have these rare gifts. It's all right to express. Don't be afraid to be you. A lot of people have been, you know, dumbing us down and holding us back and keeping us from loving ourselves and being in our greatness because they don't know how to be in there. So they'll tell you what you're doing wrong. They'll make you feel bad about who you are. You'll feel out of the norm when you're very normal. You know what I'm saying? They only want you to feel that way because they ain't tapped into their own uniqueness. And we all have rare gifts. Like, you just got to willing to do the work and, you know what I'm saying, see your potential. You just got to be realistic. People got to be realistic seeing their potential because you see yours. A lot of us do. Those of you here are bringing in this new earth, paving a new way. All right, you're bringing unconsciousness to the light. You're bringing the intelligence of the cosmos, all right? The connection to straight connection to divine source creator and all that is. You're bringing it forward and you're expressing that with your rare gifts and you're not afraid. And you're like, this is okay. It's okay to be you. It's okay to be this. It's okay to be different. It's okay to speak the truth. It's okay to stand up for yourself. You know what I'm saying? It's okay to not let people run over you. It's okay. If you're not hurting nobody else and you're doing what you're supposed to, it's okay. Don't let people feel like what you're doing is not enough. You're more than enough, okay? Yeah. You're starting to see your potential. And you're stepping into, you're supposed to step into your greatness. No more subliminal energy. Nope. Because you've done this before. This is what Spirit wants you to know. You've done this before. This is not your first time. It's not our 41st rodeos. Y'all know how many times that I'm playing with the, like, discern machine and just all these different machines and they keep looping us back and putting us in these different ailments or whatever. That's why you be having deja vu and stuff. That stuff comes because we keep getting drilled back. Our energy keep, you know, we're all connected to all things, okay? It's different timelines, different realms, different realities, but they do be playing with the realities a lot, like the Mandela effect. So when they play with those realities and you have this Mandela effect going on, you also have these, what they call, deja vu's, because it's something that you're reliving and you don't realize that you're reliving it because you've done this before. That's why every time they do that and they pull you into this new essence, it's like, damn, you already done did that. So when you have to go do it again, you kind of like, you kind of, you know what I'm saying? You just like, I got this. Because you don't even realize that you already done mastered it. You already done did these things before. You see what I'm saying? Even your soul. Sometimes we done did it over and over again in these loops that they keep on trying to, you know, cipher us in. Okay? So you've done this before. You just got to remember your soul memories as well. You got to remember your gifts and allow them to activate and turn on the line. What's up? Hold on. Wait, 1 second. Y'all. What's up? Good. Okay. Yeah, okay, y'all. She didn't know where the remote was, and I'm glad she called me anyway because I had to go close all the windows in there. It's getting dark out. All right. Yeah. Remember, your soul, your memories are coming online, whether it's your past life memories, your ancestor memories, whether it's the memories of these loops. You see what I'm saying? That we keep running through, okay? So it's just remember that you're not lost. You feel lost, but you're not lost. Go within, like, call those memories forward, call those gifts forward, you know what I'm saying? Just start, like, the other day, You go check out my TikTok channel. You see, I play the guitar. I ain't play no good. I don't play guitar. I just picked the bud up and just start fooling with it. You know what I'm saying? It didn't sound the best, but it didn't sound bad either. You know what I'm saying? So it kind of like we got these different, unique little gifts and things that's within us if we just apply ourselves. You know what I'm saying? And just try. It's in you. Just do things. It's about doing things that make you happy. You know, tap into your inner child. It's okay. And that's what they want. They suppressed that in us. When we want to be, I had to grow up fast. So I think that's why I'm so inadequate on doing these things like that, because it's like I didn't get to explore myself as a child. But I've always wanted to. It's always in me. So it's like I try to embrace it now. I try to have fun now. I try to enjoy me now. And it's like, because we're supposed to always have this innocence, this childlike presence in us. We're never supposed to, because we grown, forget our imagination and stuff. Like, our imagination is how we create. Our imagination is how we invent. Our imagination is how we connect to God. You know what I'm saying? It was first in the mind, and then you bring it to real life. And that's how we come up with solutions, through our imagination. And that's how we got through things as kids. Like, some of us who had hard lives out there, let's be for real, like, my life was hard. So I think if it wasn't for my imagination, I wouldn't have been figuring out the things I need to figure out. Like, I remember times when I was hungry, and I don't know how they make grass these days. You know, everything is generic these days. So back in the day, when I was from the country, little small town, I remember I was hungry, and something told me to pull the grass up out the ground. Like, just pull it. And then at the bottom of it was like these little white little bulb things. And something told me I can eat it. But, you know, as a child, we got imagination. You know, we're going to try stuff anyway. And come to find out, it was edible. You know what I'm saying? So I rinse it off in the little hose pipes, and I eat that grass. Tell your stomach up. It was onions. That's what it was. Them little onion roots. Yeah, that was a lot of little bug. But that was sweet, though. That was like sour. That was sour. I don't know. But I didn't know. Nobody never taught me that. But it's like, because we children, we use our imagination, and we're not afraid to try things. We explore, we figure things out. Now, that could have been something that killed my dumb ass. But it's something in me new. But see, I used to run around barefooted a lot because we ain't had shoes. Like, out of all my family and stuff, my cousin and them used to go. I had big feet for some reason. I got it from my daddy's side. I used to run around barefooted. And I didn't want to wear two little shoes because my grandma's feet was looking like this, right? I was like, I don't want my feet to look like that. She was like, well, baby, she had them bunions. Y'all know back in the day, grandma, they used to put that orange stuff on there and had that damn little razor and be shaving them bunions. And I didn't want my feet to look like that, so I used to run around barefooted. You know what I'm saying? Luckily, I did, because my feet still pretty, but I was scared of that. You know what I'm saying? I was like, let me just... So I used to run around outside barefooted all the time, so I felt like I was really more connected to the earth because of that. You know what I'm saying? And that's, I think that the energy of the earth was just letting me know things. You know what I'm saying? It's that connection that we to my house kind of couldn't find a lighter. Yeah. So that energy that came from the earth was kind of, I think it kind of spoke to me about some things. You know what I'm saying? So it's a lot of little things that we explore. It's like our imagination. That's your imagination. It's okay. We should always tap into our imagination, not be afraid to express ourselves and figure out what we can do or what's, you know. Just have fun. Be unique. All right, Hungarian energy, codependency boundaries. Yeah. Spirit want me to tell y'all, make sure you, as you going through these different, hold on, y'all. My daughter, she a little antsy right now. Hold on.
What's up,
babe? Yeah. It ain't working? I had to log into the computer for her. But yeah, this talk about codependency, and make sure you're setting boundaries. Make sure you're setting boundaries. Make sure you, like, people, because a lot of people could be codependent on your energy, all right? When you start getting around, even your family, new people, like, make sure you know that y'all are doing a fair exchange of energy. Don't let nobody just be pulling off all your energy. You know what I'm saying? People that you could be creating with, teaming up with, you know, building with, you know what I'm saying? So make sure everybody is doing a fair share of exchanges, right? Okay? So y'all can be But nobody won't be codependent on your energy. I'm feeding off you. You know what I'm saying? It's healthy boundaries, okay? Wait a minute. I feel somebody energy in here. I'm going to say this again from earlier. Don't come in here with that negative energy because I got this force field up. You know what I'm saying? When that shit going to come back and hit you, it's going to... Now it's going to knock you off your ass. Now, I'm not receiving nobody either eyes, no hate, none of that magic. Whatever you think you're doing to my timeline, let me go ahead and... Let me I'm gonna go ahead and send you some healing energies, baby, because that's what you need. You need some healing energy. You feel that love. Let me send you some light. You see that? You feel that? Oh, yeah, I know you feel it. Oh, yeah, it feel good, don't it? You see that power? That's how much power I got, baby. I can send you love, baby. You ain't gotta hate me. I'm full of love. And I'm fearless, too. I'm gonna send you that love. You see, you feel that? You feel that love coming? Yeah, that's what you're gonna get, baby. Let me help heal your soul. Yeah, because I don't even want your hate to go back to you, baby, because I want you to do never love yourself. Because I don't hate you. I don't hate you, okay? It's okay. It's okay that we, you know, we got to deal with our issues. Okay, the courage, all right? See, know that you're multifaceted and have the courage to be you, stand up. Like I said, it's okay to be unique. It's all right to be different. Let yourself be seen. Don't worry about how nobody else see you. As long as you're being positive, you're being unique, and you just being excited and stuff like that, just show up. Show up, show out. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people be scared to be themselves and show up because, you know, how people gonna, you know, we're so used to be a customer doing what everybody else doing that we want to be ourselves. And some of us don't quite know, like, because like I say, you got to tap into your imagination. You know what I'm saying? Start exploring. Start figuring out what you say. What? Go back to your childhood memory and be like, what did I used to like doing when I was a child that kind of made me happy? Even though when I had a hard life, I kind of like I say, it's kind of in you. It's like, well, what can I try that, you know, that's unique? What can I do, you know what I'm saying, outside of the box? What can I, you know what I'm saying? Just start thinking. Start going into your imagination. Start thinking weird. Like, think of stuff you never think of. Like, think of stuff that, you know, you see in the movies. Thinking, you know, just think, you know what I'm saying? I know I got superpowers, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I be seeing myself flying. I dream about me flying. So it's like, think extravagant. Know that these things are possible too. So it's just be different. It's all right to be different. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of what you got. Don't worry about how other people see you. Okay. Because one day as you show up and then it manifests, people are going to be like, well, damn. And then that's the thing too. A lot of people, that's the thing. A lot of people doubt who people are, right? And then when these people show up and keep being their unique self, when they become successful, a lot of people be mad and intimidated by it. They're like, well, damn, you, why? Because I chose to love me and be me and it gave me an opportunity. It's like, all you gotta do is do the same thing. But because people not willing to be themselves and embrace who they are, they kind of get like mad at you because they don't want to do the work. We gotta get out of that, okay? Like you say, let yourself be seen because you are multifaceted. You know that. You're from the cosmos. We all from the stars, okay? We all from the stars, all right? Have your cosmic heart. That's how you activate. That's how you chime within. That's how you manifest. That's how you be divine. That's how you heal. That's how you have all these unique gifts. That's your cosmic heart. By loving yourself wholeheartedly, it starts with you. Through love. Love is what makes you fearless. Not hate. People think, oh, if I walk around like I'm bad. You know what I'm saying? that ain't what fear come. Like, people fear you. The more you love people, like I said, people that's authentic and true, a lot of people fear that because you can see them and you truthful, you real, and you loyal. And a lot of people don't, you know, they kind of fear that because they're not living in that, right? But hopefully you motivate them too. And so when they come around you, it's kind of like, they kind of like, I don't know if I should go around that person. They're kind of scared to come around you, right? Because they're like, that person, they just... Oh, I hate that they like that. Why they gotta be so good? You know what I'm saying? Because I ain't. You know what I'm saying? Some people like don't want to be good. Some people, they comfortable in their bullshit and their dog. Okay, that's okay. But don't hate on the ones that ain't. You know what I'm saying? If you're going to be dog and you want to, you live in a day, hey, embrace it. You got the choice. But I'm telling, like I say, everybody else, the energies is no longer supporting that. So you decide what you want for yourself. Okay? That's all I'm saying. Okay? Well, you know, it's about love at the end of the day. The spirits that take baby steps. This is no race. It's no destination. It's okay to take your time with this. We all on different levels. We all on different frequencies. We all have our different ranges, okay? We got to get out of comparing and contrasting. We got to get out of competition so much. Why are we competing, y'all? Why we can't just love and support each other and be happy? We don't have to compete. Competition, if you're playing in a sport, okay, you team trying to win, but you need to win for you. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to compete with other people. When you're in your own lane, you don't have to worry about. You don't have to worry about it. Just be the greatest version of you. You know what I'm saying? We're not what we're competing for. Okay, as far as on these social media platforms. You know what I'm saying? I've been on here for years and I ain't got but 2,500 followers. I've been on YouTube for 5 years almost. I ain't got but 90 subscribers. I ain't competing. Don't do it for that. Do it for you. The more you show up for you, the energy is gonna support you. You know what I'm saying? God is gonna embrace you. You're gonna be enlightened with all you need from the cosmos. You know what I'm saying? Because what God and the divine can do for you is nothing that people can do. It's part of it. We all are part of God's plan, but we all are on different levels and we all are different souls. And certain ones of our soul frequencies have done different energetic works on our paths throughout lifetimes. So you gotta respect somebody that seems like they're more advanced, and you be like, well, damn, you know, maybe I just need to keep my nose itching, do the work. I just need to keep finding myself. You know what I'm saying? Figure out how I can get to the next level. You know what I'm saying? Figure out what your next level is, not the next person's next level. Don't worry about what the next person level is, okay? Don't worry about how you get to the next person level. Worry about how you get to your next level and take baby steps doing it. It's okay. It's all right. It's a lot of things that's gonna move forward, okay? Spirit is saying right here, follow your intuition and make sure everything makes sense before you step into something too, okay? Because some doors are about to be opening up for people, because I seen that in the very beginning of the reading. Doors are about to be opening up, but make sure it makes sense, okay? Make sure you use your intuition. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to step into the lion dance, okay? Even if you're a lion. Some lines are, and other ones are, you know what I'm saying? You don't want to deal with all that. If you got to get, you can though. But you don't want it. You want to be a soft line. You want to be a cuddly line. You want to be a loving line. You just want to be a line that just, you don't want to have to run all the time. You don't want to have to be ferocious. You know what I'm saying? Unless you have to, but I'm saying if you're not, I want to step into that line, then you see some of us ain't lions. We gazelles. So we need to stay over there under the gazelle tubes. You know what I'm saying? And hopefully next lifetime, after you have learned how to master that, being that, maybe next time you did it because you did what you supposed to do back there as a gazelle, you can be a lion. I'm just saying, I'm trying to give scenarios. You see what I'm saying? Nothing but love. Nothing but love for you too. Yeah, basically stay in your lane. That's it. And respect other people's lanes. It's okay. Don't be jealous of other people's lanes. Don't do that. Because you're going to keep holding yourself back and you going to keep coming back and learning that lesson. And next lifetime, you might have your memories. Because I do be picking up, like, moving forward that some people that are coming back, we're going to start remembering, right? And it's like, because sometimes the memories, it's another phase that's going to happen, right? If you keep your memories, maybe you remember from your past lives or whatever. Confirmation, bro, excuse me. Maybe you remember what you did do that kept you from moving forward. You be like, I ain't doing that again. You know what I'm saying? So, because sometimes if we remember what held us back, it might, I want to move forward, so I ain't going to do that again. I know what that did. I know what that got me. You know what I'm saying? So, I did get a channel message a while ago that, you know, coming into the future, new lives and stuff, we're going to start remembering our whole lives. So, and that's too. Here in this life, you know, as time goes on, we're gonna start remembering all our remembering more. A lot of people memories are coming online, and you're gonna remember what your ancestors and stuff did. And like I was saying one time ago, you have to forgive them, and you're gonna have to see those memories and be like, ah, that's why they messed up. I ain't doing that. You know what I'm saying? And see, so you're gonna know where a lot of the mistakes and what you're gonna feel it like energetically. You're gonna be led. Trust your intuition, trust your visions, trust what's being shown to you, and just follow the right guidance. You see what I'm saying? So you'll know what you need to do to go to the next level for you, okay? You get held back when you hate on the next man. It shows God. You still, exactly. You get held back like a mofo. And then what good is you getting it? If you wanna get to the next level, baby, you can't be hating on the next person. I don't ever hate. I don't hold that. I'm from my heart. I don't hold hate. I'm just not a jealous person at all. I don't work. I don't operate like that. I never have. And I ain't got nothing really. See what I'm saying? I don't never envy what other people can do or have. I'm admired by it, inspired by it. But I respect that. Hey, that ain't for me. If it was for me, God have it for me. What's for me, let me focus on and get better at that. See what I'm saying? That's it. He's gonna cause your heart out here again, okay? So yeah, being in love, being devoted to you, all right? Making your life a moving prayer. You know what I'm saying? If you want changes, all right, you see a lot of us pray, right? We pray, 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 pray. But even with prayer, you gotta put in work. Let's say make your life a moving prayer. That means if you want the prayers with the things you pray for to work out, you have to be moving along with the energies to make sure those prayers are answered, those things are still like manifestation, right? So you want things to manifest, you got to make sure you're doing things energetically, mind, body, soul, and spirit, to make sure you can attract and manifest those things so those prayers can be answered. You know, you know, a lot of people are like, man, I prayed for this, I ain't even get it. And then sometimes we pray for so big, and then it take a long time to get here. We get impatient with it, and then we start giving up on it. You know what I'm saying? You start giving up on it. Don't never give up on it. Because sometimes we got to get to a certain point, and what we need to be, God know what we need to be at energetically before we receive something that we need. Because sometimes God will give you something. Like say what I said, the devil will give you some shit too. But sometimes God give you something and then you'll take it for granted and it ain't what you thought it was. And then you disappointed because you weren't ready for it in the first place. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, faith without works is dead. That's another way to say it. Start family. You're part of a team of souls calling your support. See, this is bigger than you. This is cosmic, okay? This is coming from the stars. This is coming from the cosmos. Souls. All right, you have, and we're here. Are they forget and wonder why they getting all these tests? Yeah, they forget and wonder why they getting all these tests. You know what I'm saying? They forget. You forget you asked for this, then you? Okay, you prayed for this. Oh, you forgot you prayed for it. Oh, you thought I was just gonna get it to you? Nah, because a lot of us are messing things up anyway. But yeah, calling your support. A lot of souls, okay, so that is, okay, so a lot of us been calling in support for a long time. Now this stuff and it come from the sun. You see how they come from the sun? Your soul beings, solar, S-O-L, S-O-U-L. Your solar beings, they're coming, our energy is projected here from the sun. So a lot of us are already here. All we got to do is like, make sure we activate like, okay, so the more you energetically, like your soul, your body, avatar, the more your soul do the work, the more, I said this a while ago, a few videos back, I think the last live, that you can embody these vessels. Our upgrades is not just, we're cosmic beings, we're one with the cosmos, all right? So you see how all these lights is in her body? So you see how all these lights is coming from the sun? You can embody more than one soul energy, okay? That's where your upgrades and your DNA and your powers and all that stuff coming from, because you're being integrated with souls, okay? This avatar can embody its light. It can withhold as much light as it can, depending on the work you do in your heart. It comes from the heart, though. As you open your heart, you see how our heart big here? You see how the heart is lit up? That's these souls coming from the sun, embodying, she embodying these souls. And you can, as your heart grows, as you love yourself more and you be fearless within love, you can embody more light, because that's all it is light, right? You can embody more light souls, light codes. These souls are the codes that come within your well-being that help activate your DNA or activate what you need in you to become more rare gifts and talents and all this other stuff. And your consciousness come online. You know what I'm saying? Because we're many aspect, a multitude of different things. We can embody a lot of different things, not just one thing. God is all things. So if you think about light, we're just energy. All right? What can you house within your vessel? And it depends on how big your heart is cosmically. You can house a lot of energy if your heart can handle it. You see what I'm saying? Because if the heart stop beating, that's it. No more, right? But if you have a healthy, loving heart, that's why a lot of people that's low vibration and don't love themselves, they deal with heart problems. And it leads to what they eat. Like, if you don't love yourself, you're not going to eat the right things. You see what I'm saying? If you don't love your vessel, this is the temple of God. This is the temple. This is the house of God. So as you know, like, this is where God, the light come in at. So how can you embody the house of God, the temple of God, with God, if you're not in alignment to receive these energies? You see what I'm saying? And your life force is dipping and dampening, and then when your heart stops, you're done. So you want to embody the heart of the cosmos in love, so you can embody all of these energies, so you can move forward and enjoying life. That's how you enjoy life. My nose is itching. Okay? Heart posture. High frequencies. Yep. And it's mind, body, soul, and spirit. You gotta have it with the consciousness, what you do, mind, body, soul, and spirit. Okay? This is beautiful. Okay? The weight of the world. I know a lot of us can feel like the weight of the world is on our shoulders, but you can float. You see how she's laying in that water and she's floating? You can choose to float. You don't have to let the weight of the world, like, weigh you down. You see what I'm saying? You can choose to float. You can choose to set. You do that by setting boundaries. Ain't dealing with that. Nope. You can deal with that yourself. Oh, them your problems. Oh, nope. I got 99 problems. Nope. I'm not having them problems, because you only have those problems if you let those problems in your life. We create problems for ourselves. All right. We can't control the things that's going on around the world, but what we can do is make sure we set boundaries energetically in our consciousness, in our own reality, to make sure these things don't affect us by making the necessary moves we need to. As we heal our own well-being, our home, our internal well-being, everybody individually do the work, it'll start reflecting on the outside, and this world will be a better place. That's all it takes. The souls, everybody to do it. We got doors opening up. Here go this doors open up again. You ready to walk through this portal? All right? Because your life is like a canvas. It's like a canvas. You paint it the way you want it to paint. You see all those colors? So once you go through this portal, all right, once you go through these opportunities, this door, as you walk into this energy, this new earth that we're going into, you get to start all over and paint your life the way you want it to be painted. It's up to you. You get a blank canvas. You be the manifestor. You be the creator. You're the creator of your own life. All right? Creative accountability and manifestations. You're the artist. How do you want to paint your life? How do you want to paint it? It's up to you. Okay? Because we're here birthing new creations. It's time. All right? Going through all this deep cellular healing so we can receive our upgrades. Okay? That's how you're going to see this. When she walked through that portal, she got that long haul. Now, once you walk through that door and you creating your new earth, your new reality, your new beginning, because we all doing it individually, but at the same time, okay? Confirmation. Excuse me. We all doing it individually, but at the same time. So what are you painting for you? As you go through this portal, it's a long haul, and it's never ending. And you got different areas, different stops, different notions where you have to see yourself. Each open way is a new, say that's a new canvas, a new wall, a new essence that you can paint something new in. And that's through new lessons. You can start all over. It's never, and you can keep expanding on it. You don't have to stay with the same canvas. You can come into a whole new aspect of things. Maybe you're working on this. Oh, you like that? You created that canvas. You painted that one. Let's go paint another scenario. All right? Long as you're creating to manifest.
what you want for you. Because when you walk through that portal, it's going to be a multitude of things that you're walking into that you can create for yourself. It's never ending. What do you want? That's why you got to tap into your imagination, okay? Okay, the big picture thinking, see? They go to that portal again. All right? Because this is the upside down, right? There is worlds below us. We're coming out of this. When you walk through the portal, this is what you're walking through the portal into up here. We're coming out of this Mars energy, okay? Yep, we're going into Pleiades energy, visionaries, okay? We're connecting with communities, all right? And it's all right. Everything on the line must go, and you can question everything. Don't just take my word for it. Shit. You can ask yourself your own questions. Thank you. I think I'm gonna get off here, y'all. I gotta go. I done been up here a little bit. I really enjoyed this, though. I appreciate those who chimed in. I thank you all so much. Oh, before I get off, I do want to show. Okay, a few of my. Before I get off, let me show y'all something. A few of my manifestation tools. Okay. And since so many of y'all up here, I do have a giveaway, okay? Okay, so I'm gonna come up with a number. Let me write it down so y'all can know I ain't just trying to make nothing up. Let me find a piece of paper. Okay, give me a second. As I had said, the next time I go live, I was gonna, I got over 500 likes. I got a lot of likes. I got 24. Okay. So I'm gonna go from a number 1 through 10. Y'all can't see a paper, can you? Let me see. Not 1 through 10, because it's too many people. I'm saying 1 through. Okay, I'm saying 1 through 100. And whoever gets the closest number, I'll get the right number. You don't get the right number, you get it. You get the closest number. If you email me, my link is in the bio. I'll let you know who won. You email me your information. I'll take a lot. I'll see. Okay, let's see. Let's see the same number twice. I'm gonna quit. So does everybody know? Okay. Okay, I think. Okay, let's see. Number 87. What's the closest? Let me give a few more a chance. I think it was Colin. Let me see. Let me go back. Yeah, let me go back because I know. Camille. Camille so far is the closest. Okay. Camille 11. Oh, Camille, you got my number too, girl. It must be meant for you to get this because my number's 1 and 4. My birthday the 14th. Okay, so Camille, you got the closest. The number was let me see, I got 7. Let me see. Oh man, I'm sorry, Camille. Miss Money Cat got it on the dime. It's 99. MSS Money. I'm sorry, Camille. They came back in. Not 99. She got it, y'all. So let me write this down. My link is in the bio. Congratulations. Let me see. Let me make sure I put your information. MSS Money K11 Cat 1. Okay. Miss Money Cat 11 Cat 1. You got it right. So what you get here is this manifestation tube, okay? All right, I need you to go on my link in the bio and email me your information, okay? And we'll communicate from there, okay? So I can mail it to you. But this it. But what you'll get with this, Miss Cat, you'll get some strips. Let me show y'all, because I do manifestation tools. I do have these up for grabs, okay? These are the bigger versions, but I'm giving away the mini version, okay? So they have all kind of crystals and stuff. All of them are different, okay? This is my third eye one. Now I have them different chakras and other different ones I'm coming up with, okay? So what comes with these, I'm gonna stop saying, okay? I'm not saying it too much. With the big ones, what coming with yours, Miss Cat, is is you're gonna get these strips and an ink pen, okay? So you, I keep saying that.
All right. So you can, it'll be in here so you can write out your manifestations and you can cleanse it in your own way. You can write out your manifestation, meditate with it, put it in the sun, moonlight, however you do. Okay. But these are very powerful. And I also got copper infused in it too. Okay. Some of them got copper in them and some of them don't. So this is my third eye one. Okay. So it comes with a candle, a little tea candle, a Palo Santo stick, these strips so you can write your manifestations on, and an ink pen. So if you're interested, all right, the link is in the bio. It's my Gmail, babe. Lakita.more30@gmail.com. Let me write it down so you can get, hold up. Maybe you can see it. I'm gonna write it in. And if anybody interested in purchasing one of these, they run different prices, just let me know. I don't even know. Please, hopefully you can read that. Let me make this app right, because you can be like, where is that, honey? Okay, this is, oh, dang, I wrote all that. This, y'all gotta, excuse me, I'm getting more organized. Is that one it? Okay, this is my Gmail, okay? Lakita.more30@gmail. I've been had this Gmail forever, but this is it. lakita.more30@gmail.com. Okay, just keep, and I'm gonna get this out to you, okay? But yeah, so this is the third eye one. As y'all can see, they come with those. And then I have crystals on the bottom and the top. I put a lot of time and energy in them, all right? This is another one that I made. All right? They're very powerful. They have all kind of different crystals. And whichever one anybody will get, I'll let you know what crystals come with them, all right? But yeah, that's that one. This is the third eye one. This is the third chakra, my bad. But I make these. They're manifestation tubes. They're very powerful. This is the very first one I made. This one mine right here, y'all. I got all kinds of manifestations in here. But this one mine. This is my baby. This is the first one I made. Oh, I love it, y'all. It's so powerful. I just took it out the window today from getting charged up, you know. This is my cosmic one. This is the one I made out of like the universe. So they all gonna have all kind of different little designs and different ways they made and everything. But yeah, different crystals. Okay, show me, what's your email, Miss? I missed your email. I missed it. What you said was, you put it up there again for me, please. I really appreciate it. Let's lit up the creator's gift. Thank you for the roses and the gifts. I really appreciate it. Did you send me your, did you email me or did you tell me yours up here? I don't know. Maybe you emailed me. If you did, I'm going to check it out after I get off and up here. And also, here go the sacral chakra one. You see, you probably can't really see the yellow crystals, but I also have like some diamonds in here, but they're not real diamonds, but the crystals and stones are very real, okay? Let me show y'all the other three that I got made up, and then with the other chakras. So this is the root chakra right here. It has copper in them. So some of them have copper, some of them don't. And the ones with copper will run a little more, okay? But this is the root chakra one. And they all be individually uniquely made. This is the solar plexus one. And I think I showed y'all. Did I show y'all the heart chakra? Yeah, the heart chakra. Okay. But they all be different. I got better when I started putting the copper on them. That's when I started getting more fancy, okay? So, because I wanted everybody to see the copper that was infused in them and everything. So, some will be with copper, some won't. They'll be all made. I'm already coming with different, different Lakita dot, hello. What's this? Is that yours? Lakita.moonguide.gmail.com? Is that yours? Is that yours, Miss Money Cat 111? The one you just put up there? I wrote it down. Oh, that is you. Is this it? Oh, no, mine is Lakeith. Let me write it down again, Lord. Because you probably can't read my hand right. Let me write Nita. Lord, I'm acting like I'm 10 years old. Okay, let me write Nita. So you can see. It's in my, if you go to my profile picture, like the profile is right there in the profile. It's right there. But this is it. I wrote a little better, I hope. Oh, this is my, okay. So that is yours. Your name Lakeitha too? But yeah, these are my manifestation tubes, y'all. I am creating them. I'm waiting so I can get some more tubes. Hopefully I can, you know, keep showing them and people will be interested in them. Like I say, it will come with the strips, the Palo Santo stick, and the candle, and the ink pen. All right, each big tube. And then the smaller ones, I'm going to be making those. They'll be cheaper than the bigger ones. I'm just having to, like, slowly wait till I can buy more more items. Now, if you want to hit your girl up or cash out, you know what I'm saying, to help me out so I can go buy some more crystals and stuff, like I can make more. But until then, I'm kind of have to wait along the way and wait so I can, like, maybe sell some and, you know, slowly get my more material, okay? But I love creating. It's what I do. Is it brings me so much happiness. What I am, I'm my imagination, you know, the divine gave me that. Source, my ancestors gave me that. They've never been done before. Nobody never done anything like this. So, you know, I really take a lot of pleasure in it. I love doing it. It ain't like I really enjoy creating them. So when I'm able to create some more, I'm going to be even more happier because I feel like I can really, I already came up with some more new ideas of things I want to make, like different things I want to make. So I'm already got my mind on the next one after I finish this painting. I can at least try to do the base of one because I do got some tubes already on hand. So I just got to get some more crystals and all the other stuff that I need to create them, okay? But yeah, you will get your tube when I receive your information. I will email you or Gmail you back and let you know when I've sent it and everything. But yeah, this is yours. This is, isn't it pretty? This is the mini version, okay? And it has tiger eye, black obsidian. It's got about red agate, rose quartz, amethyst. Lupus, Luese, whatever, however you say that word. Aquamarine. It got all kind of crystals in it, baby. It's powerful too. But you're gonna love it. And like I say, I know that I made these for meditation and for the crystals can like power up and amplify my manifestations as well as I meditate with them and everything. So, and they're just so cute. And they also, the big ones, you can hang them as well too. Like you can hang them up in the window or whatever, you know, just to hang them. You know what I'm saying? But they set up well. But I really enjoy being up here and chatting with y'all, you know what I'm saying? I was like, let me jump on and go live. And I'm gonna try to go live more often so I can connect more. You know, and I send you all love. I got to get out of here because I got a few things to do to wrap it up. Thank you all for tuning in. Thank you for the likes. Thank you for the love. I appreciate all y'all. And I wish you all well. And remember to love yourself and stay fearless no matter what. Remember, the pressure only creates a beautiful diamond of light. Until next time. Bye now.